Hi, assalamu alaikum, tan sheng hao, vanakkam. My name is Muhammad Shafiq bin Muhammad Amirul.
My name is Ahmad Sabirin.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Shamil bin Azli.
My name is Shana Nazira binti Haris Fazila.
My name Nurul Izzati binti M. Aziz.
And in this video, we will do our presentation on the review of M for Malaysia.
If you are looking for a masterpiece local documentary type of film, M for Malaysia should be on your list. The documentary on the historical 2018 general election where the previous government were overthrown and 60 years conquering was directed by Aniza Rozil and Datin Dian Lee. The focus of the documentary is on the journey of Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad and the final 16 days of his campaign leading up to the election. The story highlighted on how Malaysians are sick of corrupted government led by Najib Razak. This documentary shows how the former Prime Minister Najib Razak and his corruption scandal during his period in governing the country led to the reformation of Malaysia and the change of government in 2018 general election. The hope of every Malaysian was carried by an unexpected coalition headed by the former Malaysian Prime Minister Tun Dr. Mahathir. The Alliance of Hope struggled in many challenges to execute an astonishing campaign for change in prioritizing the Malaysian people and contending the hope on every Malaysian for an integrity government.
For the case study of M for Malaysia, we have identified three political issues in the documentary. The first one is kleptocracy. Originated from Greek, kleptocracy is defined as thief and steal. However, in the political aspect, kleptocracy is defined as a government with corrupted leaders who practice the abuse of power in exploiting the resource and the people. The documentary shows the kleptocracy of Najib Razak for his corruption and scandals such as 1MDB scandal. The corruption has made Malaysia known for the corrupted cases and as a country that practice incivilities. Najib Razak was implicated for the 1MDB cases and the US Department of Justice has classified the kleptocracy as the largest kleptocracy in the history. This practice kleptocracy has oppressed the Malaysians to economically suffer with taxes. The documentary shows how the oppression is the impetus for the unity of Malaysia in overthrowing Barisan Nasional as the government. The second political issue in the case study of M for Malaysia is Think Tank. Think Tank is a body and team of specialists in giving ideas and thoughts on specific problems such as political problems and economic problems. In this documentary, the Think Tank was shown via the Alliance of Hope in campaigning against Barisan Nasional for the 2018 general election. In going head-to-head with Barisan Nasional, the Alliance of Hope figures such as Anwar Ibrahim, Lim Guan Eng, Muhammad Sabu, Wan Azizah Wan Ismail and the former Prime Minister Tun Dr. Mahathir will give their opinions and thoughts on the economic and political problems faced by the country. The prime example of Think Tank was shown in Tun Dr. Mahathir's speeches and campaign in the documentary. Tun Dr. Mahathir will use his ethos in giving and commenting the economic problems faced in the country and on the defiance of Najib Razak leadership. Tun Dr. Mahathir will use his logos in condemning Najib Razak, who was once his protege, for not being as competent as Najib Razak's father and Tun Dr. Mahathir mentor Tun Abdul Razak. Mahathir's credibility and opinions have influenced the people in selecting and voting the Alliance of Hope instead of Barisan Nasional for the 2018 general election. The third political issue is divide and conquer. Divide and conquer, or known as divide and impera is a strategy that was used by famous figures such as Niccolo Machiavelli, Julius Caesar, and Napoleon in winning the war. However, in politics, divide and conquer is an approach of conserving and gaining the power by dividing the forces into pieces so that the individual will have less power than the one who implemented the strategy. In M for Malaysia, the Alliance of Hope used this divide and conquer strategy in going head to head with Barisan Nasional in competing for the election. They will break the Barisan Nasional into pieces by only focusing on Najib Razak's defiance. Najib Razak is the face of Barisan Nasional. By outcasting Najib Razak, it means that they are outcasting Barisan Nasional as a whole from the campaign. The Alliance of Hope has divided Barisan Nasional into putting the pressure only on Najib Razak for his scandal and controversy, and they have conquered the audience and the people in believing in them to be the next government instead of Barisan Nasional.
What we learned about our country from the documentary is about the rule of law. The rule of law is an important aspect and element in a country. It is written and acknowledged as the national principle of Malaysia. The national philosophy has subjected all people and institutions to the law and constitution of Malaysia. There is no one with excessive power is above the law. However, the documentary shows the reality of Najib Razak in abusing the rule of law by believing that cash is king. Najib Razak was a corrupt leader who made Malaysia known as a corrupt country in the eyes of the world with the cases of one MDB scandal that has demolished Malaysia's credibility as a promising developing country into a country that practices incivilities. Najib Razak was a prime minister that contributed in the developing of Malaysia. However, despite the contributions, his incompetence in being the head of the government overshadowed the goods he made for the country. And as a Malaysian, we need to abide the rule of law to preserve the sovereignty of Malaysia. Next, we learn about the unity in diversity, where Malaysia is a country that diverse in multi-ethnic, multicultural, and multilingual society. Despite the differences, we should be united and solidarized in preserving the sovereignty of Malaysia. From the documentary, we have acknowledged on how the unity and the people's voices are crucial in parting the future of a democratic country. The urgency of demanding a fair election and a better country was shown from how the Malaysian was united in joining Bersih, which is one of the ways of publicly voicing the injustice and suppressing oppression. From the documentary, we as well have learned on the unity in diversity in political aspect, when differences, figures and parties with differences in philosophy agreed to form a coalition with Tun Dr. Mahathir and form as Alliance of Hope. Despite the past, they form and united in carrying the hope of the people. We have witnessed the strong spirit and the unity of Tun Dr. Mahathir and his fellow member in Alliance of Hope in bringing down the kleptocracy government through the general election. And as in the documentary, it was shown that Malaysia has changed the corrupted government through the general election.
So right now, I'm going to tell you guys about how the media can assist with patriotism and political agenda. In this modern days, media is similarly connected with society of a country. Media serve a purpose of informing and sharing information to the society in all its possible form. This is because of the media's power to influence audience by conveying the information. With the ideology of media, we believe it will help with the patriotism and political agenda. For my first point is the film industry. We see a lot of good patriotism based movie on our recent year, such as Ola Bola, Tanda Putra and M for Malaysia. The media can produce more patriotism and nationalism based film and promoting patriotism values. The film could gain people with the importance of conquering the sense of patriotism. Besides, media influence is really helpful in encouraging mainstream patriotism and political agenda. The media is able to help by raising people's voice. For example, the Bersih protest is being shown live on the media to voice out how unsatisfied the people and begging for fair election. This will encourage people to express their thoughts and opinion for sake of the nation and at the same time to develop patriotism about nation toward themselves. And last but not least is the media itself. The media should not be biased. We all know that Malaysia is a racial and ethnically diverse country. Binding citizens to boost patriotism among the people is really important. That's why the media should avoid bias such as playing race bias media, as this will affect people's solidarity. The need of spreading news that unites the people is vital to produce patriotic Malaysian. The dishonesty in the delivery of the news must be suppressed as well. The media should not partialize one party and should only expose the truth of agenda of the party.
The filmmakers and producers can produce more patriotism and nationalism-based film in increasing the sense of belonging to our country. The nationalism film, such as Olam Bula and M for Malaysia, has opened the eyes of every nation in increasing the sense of nationalism-based elements portrayed in the film. Next is the filmmakers and producers can promote the uniqueness of Malaysia through the cast in the film produced, by having cast from different races and ethnics in one film. Next is from the music industry. The media producers in music industry can produce more patriotism or nationalism-based songs such as Malaysia Ku Tercinta and Di Sini Lahirnya Sebuah Cinta. By producing more of this type of songs, it will develop the thanking feeling and sense of belonging among the listeners. Lastly, through broadcasting industry, the producers can create a segment for the television's program and radio stations with a concept of patriotism and nationalism concept, such as a program or segment that talks about the history of Malaysia with the authorized person. For the radio, the producer can produce a podcast that talks about the importance of patriotism, unity, nationalism as the main podcast in every radio station for the listeners to listen and perceive it as an important segment.
In a nutshell, M for Malaysia is a documentary that managed in documenting the political scene in Malaysia during GE14 smoothly. So, we would like to suggest the production team to keep on producing general election documentary on every general election. The more documentary produced, the more people will aware on how to choose a dedicated government, also reminding the people all the struggles. This documentary is a good documentary. However, for our recommendation, the movie producer should insert scene from the perspective of the people. This documentary is from the perspective of politician. By having the people seen, the viewer will feel more related. Secondly, we can see this film have very strong patriotism spirit. We want to see that kind of spirit in other movies too. So, other local filmmakers should take note on this and apply it in their movie. Thirdly, production team should take serious note on casting and script writing. We would like to see diverse race of casting in a movie and a relatable script that describes our country. This will make the local viewer feel close to the documentary. Overall, M for Malaysia is a must-watch movie for all Malaysians. The movie perfectly portrays the reality political scene during GE14. However, the movie is all about Malaysians gaining victory in defeating kleptocracies.
That is all for our presentation and review on M for Malaysia. To those who are watching our video right now, we highly recommend you in watching M for Malaysia. That is all from us. Thank you.